morning, dear children. How are you all? Yes, as usual, you are also excellent with me. Here, dear children, I have come with a new chapter in the grammar, that is lesson number 3 in our textbook, that is subject-verb agreement. Subject-verb agreement. We have already learned what you know that because now this chapter is in the 9th standard. What is subject? What is predicate? What is verb? That we have already learned. So, in one complete sentence, we need verb. Verb is very important. If that verb gives complete meaning in that sentence. So, in this lesson, now we'll go to first the verb. Few examples, then we will come to our lesson. That is, now see here, dear children, I have written some here, Mona sings songs. I said that in each sentence, we need subject, we need verb, then only we. So, okay, in the first sentence, which is subject here? Subject is, of course, Mona is a subject. Which is verb here? Verb is here, sings. Okay, come to the second point. Mona and Shama means this is a Mona subject. With and, we are taking here the Shama. This is also a subject. Which is verb in this? Yes, you are correct. Sing is a verb over here. Okay, we'll go to third. She has black color car. She has black color, subject, naming word, tell something, you know, state something here, the telling about the history, subject, which is here, has, here is a verb. Come to the third, fourth one, they have black color cars. Okay, they have black color cars, or we can say car also, you can say over here. They have your verb and here this is subject. Yes, come to the fifth one. Mr. and Mrs. are going to market. Are going to market. Mr. and Mrs. is a subject. Are, you know, okay, we can say are, but going to, this is a verb. We can say here subverb. Now, my life and my wife. My life and my wife, really, is the subject? Yes, dear children, this is our subject, you know, my life and my wife. So, here is a verb, this is a subject. Come to the seventh. Shoes are red in color. Shoes, naming word, the subject. Shoes, naming word, which is verb over here? Verb is here. Now, a pair of shoes. A pair of shoes. Here it is written, you know. This sentence they have added. Which is shoes, your subject here. Is here. Is a verb. Now, come to this. Those men walk fast. Those men. Men walk, subject. Here is a verb. The United Nations. Yes, that is a subject. Name. The United Nations. Subject is verb. Now, our main topic is there. What is that? Subject verb agreement with the, you know, dear children, the verb must agree with the subject. The verb must, whichever the verbs are here, must agree with the subject or the number. That must be agree, you know, the subject. The verb must agree with the subject in person and in number. This is known. The subject, I repeat, the subject must agree. The verb must agree with the subject. This is very important in the person and in number. This is called the subject-verb agreement, or the other word is there, we can say the concord. Now come to the point over here, Mona. Mona, how many do you know subjects? Singular subject, plural subject, right? Then in that first person, second person and the third person. So singular, plural, and in that you know we say that singular, first person, second person and the third person. So here we see Mona sings songs. Okay, Mona, singular or plural? Yes, you are correct. It's a singular. So singular subject. Singular subject gives a singular verb. You know, Mona sings. S-I-N-G, sing, plural, sings, singular. So Mona sings songs. Now here, Mona and Shama. Two girls are there, two subjects are there. So Shama sing. Can you hear? See, dear children, wherever I have marked with the red, that is very important. Subject and verb. You see here, difference. The Mona and Shama here, we have written here sing. Sing songs. She has. So here we have written a plural. Because we are plural. That only we are going to be learned now in this lesson. Just I have given you examples. Now she has black color car. She has. She, singular. Has. So here, has black. Now see, they. Plural subject. So plural verb. They have black color cars. Mr. and Mrs. Husband bhi hai, wife bhi hai. Mr. and Mrs. Two personalities are going to market. My life and my wife. Are they two? See here. Here it is also and. Here also it is and. Here also it is and. But here, two personalities are here. Can you see here two personalities? My life and my wife. I think so. For my wife only I am telling my life. Right? So the one personality is there. So my life and my wife is beautiful. Now, shoes are red in color. Shoes are red in color. Yourself. But the same sentence when I'm attaching with a pair of shoes. A pair of shoes is red in color. Are you getting any difference here? Those men walk fast. Which is your subject? Men. Walk fast. Subject, plural. Walk, plural. When with the verb, when we are adding S, that is a singular. So here, walk fast. The United Nations, you know, we say that United Nations of Kingdom, that the United Nations. That S is there. This is a naming word. Even though S, we are acting here, we have here is not an effective body for the world. So, I think so, dear children. This, somewhere we have written plural, somewhere we have written singular. Why all these things? Here the shoes, here a pair of shoes, here the adding the plural S. See, all these rules we are going to be learned in this lesson. So dear children, we will come, these some basic rules are there that we have to follow for this lesson, that is subject verb agreement. So dear children, we come to the point, that is rule number one, that is basic rule of subject verb agreement. That is rule number one, that singular subject takes singular verb. Singular subject takes singular verb and plural subject takes a plural verb. See here, I'm talking about this, singular subject takes a singular verb, plural subject takes a plural verb, when the subject is in third form. Third, when we are talking about the third personality, you know, that comes, the singular subject takes a singular and the plural subject takes a plural. We'll come to the example. It is very easy to see. When we see the example that they are in the class or in the classroom. They. Who? They. Not I, not you. They. The third personality. Right? So, they are in the classroom. the plural. And here also plural, the are is plural. So when the subject is in third, they are in the class or they are in the class room. What is the second one? Those men walk fast. Those men walk fast. That is, you know, plural. Means those men walk fast. Those means the men. Men. What is men? Plural. That is, this is the plural. And so this is also a plural noun. Okay. But what is the singular? I have not written here the singular. What is that singular? What we can take? The singular of subject and singular. Okay. Here we can take Sita is a clever girl. Sita is a clever girl. Sita, singular. This is singular. Is also a singular. Understand? Now, what we can say? That just now see here. Mona sings a song. Mona, singular, and sings, singular, so songs. So here, when Mona, not I, not you, Mona, talking about Mona, so that is the third form. Keep in mind, this, the singular subject takes a singular verb, plural subject takes a plural verb, when that is in the third form. Okay, then what about the other thing? When the subject is not in third form, when the subject is not in third form, what you will take? Takes a plural verb. When the subject is not in third form, it will take the, it takes plural verb. See, I see news daily. I see news daily. See, I, first person. I see, singular, you know, singular. We, plural. What is this? See, plural. This, plural. S-E-E-C-S-E's. That is, suppose I am telling you, Sarah sees television daily. Sees. That is the singular. But we are talking about the when the subject is not in third form. See, we see news daily. We see news daily. The singular also, and here with the plural also. When the subject is not in third form, we always take a plural noun. I read book daily. I read book daily. If you are writing over here, read. Here also, we read news daily. Read. Plural. Not reads. Not reads. So here, this is a first rule of, that is basic rule of rule number one, that is the singular subject takes a singular and plural subject takes a plural in the third, with the examples we have seen. And when the subject is not in third form, we are taking the plural subject. Now we will see the rule number two. Now we will see basic rules of that subject and verb agreement, that is rule number two, that two singular subject plus and. When two singular subject attaching with and takes always a plural verb. You know, now see here, Abhishek and Alvin are brothers. What is our rules here? When two singular subject, two singular nouns adding with an takes always a plural verb, because there many nouns are there, you know, one, more than one nouns are there, there we are always adding the aggregate verb plural. So here Abhishek and Alvin means this is a noun and this is a noun attaching with an. We are taking plural noun, so there, sorry, plural verb. So this is our plural verb. Dear children, don't go to my handwriting. My handwriting is best handwriting. You know, I'm always positive. So try to understand that. Okay, now we go to the second point, that is she and I. Two nouns are there, two singular subjects are there. She and I were studying means this is a plural verb. This is I, one noun. This is I, the other noun. So it takes a plural. Very easy to understand, you know. And as we learn from the beginning, you know, from nursery, pre-primary to till the this class, we are English. English is very good English. So it's very easy to understand. Now this attaching, we are talking about attaching and. Now the exception case is there. Which exception? Two. The two subjects. When two subject express one idea. Two subjects express one idea. That is, it takes a singular verb. See here, two subjects express one idea. Not the different. Here Abhishek and Alvin, different personalities. Here the she and I, the different personalities. But here, attaching with and giving one idea, there we always use a singular noun. See the for example, bread and butter. Bread and butter is not, bread is not different and butter is not different. Bread and butter is one. So we have used here, what we have used here? The singular verb. Here as we said, that takes a singular verb. Bread and butter is essential for life, even though attached with and. But it is a one idea, so we are using singular verb. Now go to the second one, slow and steady. Wins the race, slow and steady wins. We have not written here win, it's a wins, singular. You know the singular verb, here the singular verb. Now what is third is Tom and Jerry. These are the two, you know, but it one idea. Tom and Jerry, we always say together like bread and butter. So Tom and Jerry is a funny series. So this is two singular subject attaching with and always takes a plural. But the same thing, if that expression, that the subjects express one idea, we are taking the singular subject. We'll go to the next rule, that is rule number 3, use of collective nouns. Which are the collective nouns? Collective nouns, the class, bunch of, you know, the bouquet, the bunch, the flocks, cattle, and the family, crowd. These are the collective nouns, you know better. So singular, that use of collective nouns, it depends completely whether we have to take the singular noun or whether we have to we have to take a singular verb or a plural verb. Which verb is agreed with that noun according to that sentence, depending the meaning of that sentence, we are attaching. If the singular is there, attach singular verb. If that meaning comes the plural, attach, add plural verb. Now see here the five examples I have taken. The family are our strongest support. The family are our strongest support. Here the family we have taken here is, you know, the plural verb. We have taken here the plural verb. It is a plural verb, you know. And you see, the family is, this is also a family. This is also a family. The family is driving out for a week. The family, jo hai, ek family that we have taken, a single family, is going out for a week. So, according, dear children, if it is very confusing for you, you know, you can translate that sentence in your own language, either Marathi or either Hindi or either whatever your language is there. Then you can come to know that. Wo ek family aaj din ke liye bahar ja rahe hain. Translate that into in your own mother tongue. Then it's very easy whether that is plural or whether that is singular. So what verb you have, which verb you have to attach, it gets you very easily. Now here the singular is there.
So the family is, that is a singular. Come to the family. The family are each doing the different work.
तो फैमिली के हर एक अलग 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 जो व्यक्ति है, मेंबर जो है, अलग अलग काम कर रहे हैं. आर यू गेटिंग?
सी हियर अगेन, हियर वी हैव रिटन द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट सपोर्ट, हियर वी हैव रिटन द सिंगुलर, बट द सेम फैमिली इज देयर, बट द मीनिंग इज डिफरेंट ऑफ दैट सेंटेंस. सो द फैमिली आर द प्लूरल, ईच डूइंग अ डिफरेंट वर्क, अलग अलग. सो वी हैव रिटन देयर आर. नाउ सी द कलेक्टिव नाउन ऑडियंस. Audience, the public, when we sit in front of us for any program, the audience, collective noun, and it shows the one, you know, one, that is audience is, that is a singular verb, you know, that is we have written the singular verb. The audience is very excited. Come to the crowd. काफी क्राउड जो जमा रहती है. क्राउड, द क्राउड इज कमिंग इन ह्यूज नंबर. इज कमिंग, काफी लोग एक साथ जब रहते हैं. मेनी पीपल व्हेन कम टुगेदर वी से क्राउड. सो दैट क्राउड वी आर यूजिंग द सिंगुलर नाउन. यू नो दिस इज अ वर्ब, सिंगुलर वर्ब वी हैव यूज्ड. सो डियर चिल्ड्रन, इन द सिंगुलर यूज ऑफ कलेक्टिव नाउन्स, इट कंप्लीटली which verb you have to, is little bit confusing, but if you translate that in your own language, in your own mother tongue, you will get an idea, and it's very easy to find out whether which verb we have to add there, or which verb is agree for that sentence. Okay, now we come to the rule number four. What is that? If in this noun, everybody, somebody, subject is everybody, somebody, nobody, anybody, anyone, everyone, someone. When this noun comes, you know, this subject comes, everybody, somebody, nobody, nothing, you know, then it takes always a singular noun. It always takes a singular noun. See here, nobody is a perfect, nobody. कोई भी परफेक्ट नहीं. इज अ सिंगुलर नाउन. सो इट्स अ सिंगुलर नाउन. नोबडी इज सिंगुलर वर्ब वी हैव टेकन. वी हैव टू टेक विथ ऑल दीज वर्ब्स, वी हैव टू टेक ऑलवेज अ सिंगुलर वर्ब. सो हियर नोबडी इज परफेक्ट इन द वर्ल्ड इज सिंगुलर. एवरीवन इज गुड इन स्टडीज. Everyone is good in studies is singular. Something is better than nothing. Something is singular verb. So in this case, you know, in the rule number five, when this noun comes, you always use which verb agrees there. So singular verb agrees for this. Now we go to the rule number five. Now we will come to rule number five. That is, if subjects are joined by or, nor, either, neither, the verb agrees with the nearest subject. That is, verb agrees with the third person. I repeat the sentence. If subjects are joined by or, nor, either, neither, the verb agrees with the nearest subject. You know, nearest subject, that is with the verb agrees with the third form. Now we come to the example. What is that? Neither he nor his sister. Neither he nor his sister was there. What is there? Agrees with the third person. Nearest verb, I repeat. See, joined by or not, and it is attached with neither nor his sister. Which is the nearest noun? Which is the nearest subject? His sister. His sister? His sister. Uski behen. third form. So that arrows. Now verb aggregates takes a singular, takes a nearest subject. Verb aggregates with the third person. That is to say, third person is singular. Third person is singular. Nearest noun, that we have taken a singular verb. What my point? We'll go to the third second. He or his friends. He attaching with or. He or his friends are to be friends. Nearest subject. He or his friends. Third person. The third person is here. Which is the third person here? Singular or plural? Yes, plural. So add plural verb. So here the singular and here we have attached the plural verb. Okay, then come to the third example. The third example is neither the students nor the teachers. Neither the students nor the teachers are responsible for this. So which is the nearest subject? Or you can say the nearest third person? The teachers. The teachers. Third personality. The nearest subject. So what is that? The teachers? Plural. So must take the plural verb. So that is are. I think so. Here it is very clear. Once again I say, if the subject are joined by or, nor, either, neither, the verb at least with the nearest subject, and that is nearest subject means the third form of. So here neither he nor his sister is a singular, so we have taken was. He or his friends, third nearest the this, third person is the friends, so it is a plural, we have taken the plural verb over here. Now the neither the students nor the teachers, teachers plural, so we have taken here plural. Now we come to the rule number 6. That is, when the plural noun comes between a singular subject and its verb. Verb agrees with the singular subject. What is that? Each of the apples. Here we have written apples. What is that? Plural. But the subject. When the plural noun comes between the singular subject. This is a plural noun. Coming between the subject and its verb. So each. So it. Juice. Each of the apples. Eight apple. Each of the apple. So always comes the singular and verb at least with the singular subject, that is each. That is so each. So you see the meaning also, dear children. Okay, if you are getting confusion, come to the meaning. Kya is the meaning? Each of the apple is juicy. Usme se har ek apple, har ek kya kehte use? Say juicy hai, har ek. So it's a singular. So we have written here is. Neither of the men. Men. It's a plural. But what is that? When the plural noun comes, when the plural noun comes between the singular subject and its verb, always takes the singular. So here neither, we have taken here was. So it's a singular. So it's very easy. Dear children, whatever we have learned today, today's here up to rule number 6. Few rules are there that will be continued, you know, it will be continued tomorrow. And whatever I have taught you, go through that, dear children. And one worksheet we had been given you on the open day. Open that, and whatever rules I have taught you today, so go through those examples. I think so 15-20 examples are there in that worksheet. So the rules which I taught you today, go through those examples, solve that, and we will continue the rest rules in tomorrow session. I hope you understood complete verb and agreement, so you continue with your worksheet. Thank you and have a nice day.